मैत्रेयाय विद्महे संजय बाबाय धीमहि तन्न सर्व प्रचोदयात्। ॐ सायित्रयाय विद्महे संजय बाबाय धीमहि तन्न सर्व प्रचोदयात्। सायित्रयाय विद्महे संजय बाबाय धीमहि तन्न सर्व प्रचोदयात्। ॐ शांति 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 सर्व विघ्न विनाशाय सर्व कल्याण हेतवे पार्वती प्रिय पुत्राय श्री गणेशाय नमो नमः। माया देवी प्रिय पुत्राय श्री संजय साई नमो नमः। ॐ शांति शांति शांति। गुरु ब्रह्मा गुरु विष्णु गुरु देवो महेश्वर गुरु साक्षात् परब्रह्म तस्मै श्री गुरुवे नमः। ॐ शांति शांति शांति। चिरस्पर्श भगवान बाबा त्वं शरणं मम।
What happened? Just
we can hear now. Speak. We can hear now.
मंगलम ओंकारा मंगलम गुरुर् मंगलम गुरुपादा मंगलम साई मंगलम श्री संजय साई पादा मंगलम। लविंग कोटि प्रणाम अट द डिवाइन लोटस फीट ऑफ आवर डियरेस्ट गॉड and Guru, Bhagwan Sri Sanjay Sai Baba. The Lord responds to a devotee according to the devotee's feelings. When devotion has grown stronger, the devotee desires a still closer relationship. Now, we have different types of relationship. Mother, father, child, teacher, grandmother, grandfather, uncle, auntie, like that. But there is one relationship which binds us closely together. That is Sakyam, the friendship level. We all need a good friend to guide and goddess. Imagine if God himself, if we follow the master and be close to him and tell everything to him and follow his advices. What great bliss each one of us will get in life. In the Sakyam stage, the devotee sees God as his friend. A friend is always your well-wisher, but it should be a good friend, because Baba once said, when people have money, they have lots of friends. Hello, 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 when you have money. When no money is there, hello becomes hollow. It just goes away. But who can be your best friend? God will never forsake us in any circumstances. A friend is always dear and near, and if we have true friend, we have got something special in our life. Everything is a prasad. In our life, everything is a prasad. So, when we see God to be the companion by our side, in every relationship, if we are seeing Him, always talking about His glories, Shravanam, singing His songs, bhajans, and singing His glories, Kirtanam, contemplating on the Lord all the time, Smaranam, serving His lotus feet by serving everybody, Padasevanam, worshipping the lotus feet, Archanam, giving salutations at the lotus feet, Vandanam, considering Lord as our only master, Dasyam. And when we are crossing this, we come to the stage where we earn only to be with the Lord, nothing else. All the time He is there inside us. That is like it becomes a Sakyam level. And from this, we move on to Atmanivedanam. So the friendship is a very great thing. And in Sakyam stage, there is a story in Bhagavad Gita about Lord Krishna and Arjuna. Arjuna was said to be at the Sakyam level with Lord Krishna. He always worshipped. And once Krishna and Arjuna, both of them, were going through a forest. At that time, they eventually reached a village. Krishna was feeling hungry and Arjuna also was feeling hungry. So they decided, they saw one big mansion, big building. So Krishna said, we'll go there and ask for food. But they were dressed up as ordinary people. So both of them went to the rich man's home and they asked the residents for some food. The rich man, instead of giving food, he gave lots of shoutings and abuses and sent them off. On departing, Krishna blessed him. May you get more and more riches. Arjuna observed this, but he kept silent. Then they were walking for some more time and they reached a poor man's hut. The same way, Krishna and Arjuna went to that poor man's house and they asked for some food. The poor man invited them with lots of joy and he had some milk. So he brought nice milk for them. That was all he had in the house. Not knowing who they were, why they have come, this man was not knowing anything. But Atithi Devo Bhava, guests are God, thinking that this man was offering milk. He was a great devotee of the Lord. And he was very happy. Krishna just smiled at that man and they left, thanking for giving the milk. And when they came out, Krishna told to Arjuna, let this man's cow die. Let this man's cow die. Now this is too much for Arjuna. He said, first we went to one house, they didn't give us anything. And Krishna said, may you become more rich. Now we have come to a poor person's house and he gave milk. And Krishna is telling, may your cow die. What is this, Krishna? How can you give boon like this? Can the Lord go wrong anytime? Never. Whatever he says is Veda Vakya. Being a true friend of Arjuna, Krishna revealed the secret. His blessing for the rich man to prosper more was actually a curse from Arjuna's point of view. But at the spiritual level, it meant something. The rich man was already very arrogant because of his riches. He had no compassion in his heart or for the fellow beings. By giving him more riches, he was damned to stay in that arrogance, which would increase. From the spiritual point of view, it was a curse. But from the worldly perspective, it was taken to be a blessing. Krishna sees only from the spiritual standpoint, because it is that which brings us happiness and sorrow, and not the amount of money we have. We devotees must learn to see things differently. Nobody can question God. Why this is happening to me? Why this is happening to other person? No. Krishna's curse for the old Brahmin was actually a blessing, because Krishna revealed that the Brahmin had detached himself from the world, but he was only attached to his cow. So to remove his attachment to the cow, Krishna took it away. From that time onwards, the Brahmin learned to depend solely on the Lord for his existence. He gave himself up to his care. It was a great step for that man. So that was a curse from the worldly standpoint, but it became a blessing from the spiritual standpoint. The Lord cannot bear to see a fault of his devotee. He only wants the growth of the devotees. So that is why when we go to God, when we go near Avatar, when we go to Vrindavan Ashram, when we just, you know, like sit in the bhajan hall, you know, Swami is just walking and Swami's smile, Swami's look, everything literally transports us to the other world, because we only, you know, like that love for everybody, whether rich or poor, or whether having, not having, beggar or whomsoever it may be. But when that Divya Drishti of God falls on us, we are feeling that love from within. Automatically, when we sit there, no other thoughts come to our mind. We are totally drenched in the love of Bhagavan. That is, you know, like we become, you know, like how when we meet our friends and talk to them, we just forget ourselves. The same way, when we are with God, in his friendship, in his look, in his Divya Vachan, in every action of the Lord, we only see the oneness, closeness, and that Sneha Bhava. That Sneha Bhava is there in the Lord, because he is friend of everyone. Not only, never, you know, like that is why we can not choose our parents. because our karma decides to which mother we need to be born. But we have the right to choose the right friend and good friend. That is in our hand. And the best friend for us, who can be our best friend? Only Bhagavan can be our best friend. God is love, love is God. We want to go with the love, because in friendship there is giving and forgiving. You know, love is giving and forgiving, self is getting and forgetting. Love all in the spirit of your love. Love all, serve all. Understand that love and peace is what we need. Love all, serve all. In every single thought, burden deep. In every single thought, word, and deed. Once we start practicing this, we have the closeness of the Lord, and there is enormous joy, happiness, forgiving things, no jealousy. It is, you know, like seeing others progress, feeling happiness. There are so many positive qualities develop within us when we look from that point of view. Friendship is such a beautiful thing. So the whole world is God. He is Sahasra Sirisha Purushaha. So everything belongs to him. So to be a friend with the God, we need to be friendly with everyone, everything, so that we feel the joy of universal love. With this, Koti Pranam, my dear Bhagwan. Keep all of us as your friend. Help us to rise up to that level so that we give ourselves, and you are there to guide and guard us forever. Charan Spar Swami, Tvam Charanam Mama.
Charan Spar Swami, Baba, Tvam Charanam Mama.
My humble pranam at the lotus feet of Bhagwan Baba. Happy Guru Purnima. Om Sai Ram, Om Sai Ram, Om Sai Ram. Hami sampurna kalakar Darjeeling Kharsang bata chhau. Sarvapratham keyboard ma hunuhuncha Rupesh Rasail ji, ani harmony ma hunuhuncha श्रीमान उपेन्द्र प्रधान ज्यू, अनि बांसुरी में हुनुहुन्छ श्री संजय प्रधान ज्यू, अनि लीड गिटार में हुनुहुन्छ श्री गुलशन राय ज्यू, अनि बास गिटार में हुनुहुन्छ श्री शिवराज बिन्द्रा अनि तबलामा हुनुहुन्छ श्री प्रवेश गजमेर अनि म सुचिता थापा प्रणाम साइराम साइराम साइराम
जय बनना सीधी दिया भैया। Yeah.
शायरा Thank you.
Bye.
My humble pranam at thy divine lotus feet, Bhagwan Baba. Guru Bina Jag Nai Adhiyaro. So true. Without Guru, our life is meaningless. These words have given justice to my God and Guru, Bhagwan Sri Sanjay Sai Baba. Suchita Baini, may Bhagwan always be with you. May he give you peace, prosperity, and love. It was a beautiful, wonderful bhajan session. And Suchita, I know as soon as you found out about Bhagwan Baba, you have been connected with us. This means a lot for us. Only His divine grace would have done this. Without His grace, you and us, we would not be connected at all. But not only now, if possible, we would like you to join us in all our upcoming programs too. I am positive that by His divine grace, you will be singing His divine glory time and time again. Take care. Stay safe. Once again, may Sai Ma bless you and keep you safe under His warm wings. Om Shri Sai Ram. Transpash Bhagwan Baba. Asato ma sadgamaya tamaso ma jyotirgamaya mrityur ma amritam gamaya om shanti Shanti, Shanti, Sarvesham Swastir Bhavatu, Sarvesham Shantir Bhavatu, Sarvesham Purnam Bhavatu, Sarvesham Mangalam Bhavatu. Om Shanti, Shanti, Shanti.
जीवा सुखिनो भवन्तु समस्त जीवा सुखिनो भवन्तु समस्त जीवा सुखिनो भवन्तु ॐ शांति 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 राजातिराज योगिराज परब्रह्म सच्चिदानंद सद्गुरु भगवान श्री संजय साई बाबा जी की आबत बांधवाय अनाद रक्षकाय भगवान श्री संजय साई बाबा जी की आरोग्य प्रदाय अष्ट ऐश्वर्यदाय भगवान श्री संजय साई बाबा जी की जय चरण स्पर्श स्वामी त्वम शरणम मम
चरण स्पर्श भगवान बाबा त्वम शरणम मम।